We are standing on the shores of Eagle Harbor. And Eagle Harbor is a beautiful natural harbor on the east side of Bainbridge Island. Bainbridge Island is an island in central Puget Sound. It's about a half hour ferry ride west of Seattle. This site was added to the nation's Superfund site list in 1987 because of creosote contamination in the soil, in the groundwater, and in the sediments on the bottom of Eagle Harbor. The Squamish tribe lived here for tens of thousands of years before European contact. We've worked closely with the tribe for years now. The company that operated here made telephone poles and railroad ties and pier pilings, and they did that by treating wood with creosote and other chemicals to preserve the wood.
It's a thick, gooey substance that on a hot summer day, you might see dripping down a little bit on a telephone pole. It's very harmful. It can burn your skin. Those pHs are so concentrated here before the cleanup that we had to use special protective gear to make sure we didn't get any of that on our skin. It was staggering how contaminated the intertidal areas were. We found pools of creosote in the water that you could literally see your own reflection in, and dead crabs and other marine life everywhere. It was really dramatic for me as a brand new EPA scientific diver to see that.
So the three main remedies that have been put in place so far are to pump and treat the groundwater and to put a seawall around the outside of the site, and that prevents the groundwater from leaving. And then the third remedy is a cap, a thick layer of clean sand on the bottom of the seafloor, and that's burying the contamination and protecting the fish and crabs and other organisms that live out there. And we extended that cap in a couple phases, and so today there's more than 70 acres of the harbor that are capped. We rely a lot on our dive team and our ROV team. They're like our eyes and ears on the ground. They allow us to go out and see the seafloor.
It's been a great experience working with such a great team here at the Wyckoff Superfund site. Not only the project manager, but also the divers as well. You know, since 1985, over 30 years of EPA scientific divers working on this project. New technologies that we're using underwater here might be human powered, but they're also, you know, machines like remotely operated vehicles to take video of the protective cap that's in that area and figure out what repairs are needed.
EPA having its own dive team and ROV team saves the agency a lot of money. Here are two lights for better visibility underwater. Here's a little grabber arm in case it needs to attach something or grab something. We have a sonar device here, which allows the EPA to see through low visibility conditions.
When we dive here now, it's a dramatic difference. The nearshore areas, there's so much life. We see crabs, we see shellfish, we see moon snails, we see all sorts of life.
Although a lot of cleanup work has been done to date, some challenges do remain. We partner with a whole lot of people and agencies. The state of Washington Department of Ecology has been a close collaborator and partner with EPA. Looking to the future, we want to get the site cleaned up so that we can turn all of the site over to the city for use as a park.
The views are amazing. It's a regionally significant setting to have such an amazing public access to the water. Washington State is most of the tidelands are privately owned, and so access to the water is always scored very, very high whenever we ask the community what it wants more of.
One thing that Pritchard Park provides is a beautiful beach, and a lot of kayakers come here to this beach. We have a rowing team, our high school rowing team, which is fantastic. It's been doing well, rows in this area.
This cleanup is just one of many actions that EPA is taking to protect and restore the resources of Puget Sound. And I can't overstate the importance of Puget Sound to this region, to the people, to the economy. It's essential. We could not have the life we have here without a healthy Puget Sound.